dressed.
Here's a Saxon book, Math 7-6 in Criminal Development. Okay, these are your two authors. No picture. Okay. What else doesn't it have? Okay, there's no pilot districts, it doesn't have eight authors, it's not reviewed by 40 teachers, it's not NCTCC compliant, there is no problem solving, it's black and white, there are no pictures of people, there are no diverse names. Okay, that must mean this is a bad textbook. Okay, adding, subtracting fractions, three steps. Put the problem in the right shape, deal with the operations in the case, simplify the answer, reduce or convert. So, the steps are shape, operate, multiply. Write the problem with the common denominators. Add the numerator, simplify the answer, in this case, convert. Here's another one. 1/2 1/6. Write the problem with the common denominators, add the numerator, simplify the answer. It showed you exactly how to do it. Solution. Here's another one. Example. Here. It should take all of about 5 minutes or 10 minutes to do all of these things. And it shows you exactly how to do them. See, what a concept. And everything is in one book for the entire year. Here, we get to add mixed numbers. Remember the other kids had about 5 minutes to come up with all these ways. Now, if you want to add a mixed number, like this, write the fractions with a common denominator, add the whole numbers and numerator, simplify your answer when possible. Shows you exactly how to do it. We use the same rules. There's no investigation. Multiplying mixed numbers. Mixed numbers works with a whole number and a fraction written together like this. Mixed numbers can be multiplied and divided just like fractions. It tells us there are three steps: write in fraction form, multiply numerators and denominators, simplify the answer. Example, multiply this times this. Okay, here's another one. Subtracting mixed numbers with borrowing. Okay, that's interesting. Now our kids in the CMP are supposed to figure this out. Write with common denominators, then we subtract the whole numbers of fractions and simplify when possible. Sometimes subtracting is interesting to regroup. Wait until the fractions have been written with common denominators before regrouping. Okay, we write the fraction combo, we group if necessary through the regrouping. We simplify if possible. CMP says nothing about regrouping. Dividing mixed numbers. We practice multiplying. Fractions chart tells us the following rules in dividing. Write the numbers in fraction form, change the division problem to multiplication problem by inverting the second fraction. Multiply, simplify when possible. Jeez, that must be painful. Here's an example. This divided by that, write as fractions. Invert the second fraction, change symbol. Multiply numerators and denominators, simplify when possible. Okay, I'm sure all of our CM people can figure this out and write it out without any help from the teacher. Fractions chart. Okay, this is what an index from Saxon looks like. Okay, if addition with fractions actually will tell you how to do it. There's no mention of algorithm. Okay, notice that benchmark is not here. Oh my God, Saxon does not have benchmarks. Of course, real mathematicians don't use benchmarks. Here, common denominator. Denominators, there's a common denominator. Now, the lowest common denominator is not here by name, but whenever they do a common denominator, they in fact do use a lowest common denominator. Here's another one here. There's common denominator, and there's how you comparing numbers and comparing fractions. Shows you exactly how to do it. Here's another part of our index. Least common multiples right there. Mixed numbers. As decimals, dividing, multiplying, simplifying, and subtracting. It's all there, and they give you an actual method. Here's another one here. Multiplication with dollars, fractions, integers, mixed numbers, and they give you a method. Here we go. Where's problem solving? Problem solving is not there. Therefore, Saxon must be a bad textbook, not like CMP. And there we have it.